This evening, the superintendent's report. I believe it's a report that I've been waiting to actually make since November 4th of 2015. Our mission statement, everyone.
As a unified community, the East Ramapo Central School District is committed to educating the whole child by providing a healthy, safe, supportive, engaging, and challenging learning environment.
Gee, you sound good. Our vision statement.
We will become proficient in all that we do.
Did I hear someone put extra emphasis on all? Do we want to read that again?
We will become proficient in all that we do.
I knew I heard that. In our five-point plan, we want students and staff who are
healthy, safe, supportive,
absolutely. And our goals, success in the early years, healthy, safe, supported, engaged, and challenged, everyone, motivated, confident, empowered, critical thinkers, mastery of academic subjects, high school graduation, and readiness for college and career. And that backdrop is actually a picture of 400 students who attended the commitment ceremony at Ramapo High School in October of 2018. And it is my favorite photo, and I cherish it each and every day. East Ramapo Central School District. Every student succeeds at, commonly known as ESSA, School and District Accountability Status Report. The U.S. Department of Education and the New York State Education Department is committed to fostering equity for all students, but I needed this closer. And this really is a gold microphone night. And those of you in the audience know what I mean by if you know what I mean by gold microphone night, just raise your hand. There you go. All right, it's a gold microphone night. For this reason, the U.S. Department of Education has expanded the measures for school support, accountability, and student success to move beyond state testing to educating the whole child. This is absolutely music to our ears because since 2015, this district has focused on educating the whole child. Not only educating the whole child, but educating the whole adult. We want students and adults who are healthy, safe,
engaged, and challenged.
That's right. So, East Ramapo Central School District will continue to strategically plan to meet the needs of our students and teachers through our established goals, which are aligned to ESSA. And our goals, and let's read them again, our goals really are aligned to ESSA. These are the goals that we established during the summer of 2016. Let's read them again, everyone. Success in the early years, healthy, safe, supported, engaged, and challenged, motivated, confident, empowered, critical thinkers, mastery of academic subjects, high school graduation, and readiness for college and career. As stated, New York State Education Department has revised our accountability system to look beyond just student test scores to ensure that we are educating the whole child with a focus on growth and progress through multiple measures. And there are 7 measures to be exact. There is a focus on differentiated accountability and supports. There's a focus on recognition of high performing and rapidly improving schools, now referred to as recognition schools. There is a focus on shared responsibility, educators, parents, and community in student success, coming together in student success. New York State will use multiple measures of success to identify schools beginning with the 17-18 school year results. While the number of indicators has increased beyond test scores, there is a stronger focus on student growth and progress. Here in East Ramapo Central School District, our mission remains the same: to educate the whole child. Our vision, we will become proficient in all that we do. I am so excited to note that the mission and vision of our district, as well as our strategic planning goals, are in alignment with the 7 indicators from ESSA, from State Ed. For elementary and middle schools, there are 5 indicators. There's 3, there's 2. And I'll read them to you. Elementary and middle schools will be held accountable for 5 indicators. Composite performance, that's academic achievement in English language arts, ELA, mathematics, and science. Number 2, student growth in ELA and mathematics. Number 3, progress of ELS towards English language proficiency. Number 4, academic progress in ELA and math. Now listen, number 5, chronic absenteeism. For high school, there are 6 indicators. Composite performance, for instance, academic achievement in ELA, mathematics, science, and social studies. The graduation rate, not only just a 4-year graduation rate, but 5th-year and 6th-year cohorts. Progress of ELS towards English language proficiency, academic progress in ELA and math, chronic absenteeism, here it goes, college, career, and civic readiness. New York State's accountability system is currently based on differentiated identification around the concept of need. Those schools that need the most support will get the most attention from the state. NYSET will identify and has identified 2 types of schools in need of support based on growth and progress tied to identified indicators. Targeted Support and Improvement Schools, that acronym now is TSI, identified for subgroup performance. Improvement requirements are managed by the district. A school will be preliminarily identified as TSI. Now I want to go back. Did you hear what I said? The TSI schools are managed by the district. Okay. A school will be preliminarily identified as TSI if the school was in priority school or focus status accountability in 2017-2018, And if any of the school's accountable subgroups met any one of the scenarios prescribed by state ed. So that's the first type, TSI schools. The second is CSI schools, Comprehensive Support and Improvement Schools, identified for all student performance and graduation rate. Improvement requirements are done with state oversight. Okay? So TSI is managed by the district. CSI is done with state oversight. All right? Additionally, for those schools that have demonstrated a greater need for improvement and oversight by our state education department, there is receivership, which requires that schools meet demonstrable improvement. Let's get away from that slide. Right. To assist in clarity related to the new SED system, it is important to know that our system now is all about levels. Level one is the lowest. Level four is the highest. Based on 2017-2018 data, levels are assigned to the seven indicators that I just shared, which identifies the type of schools and districts in need of support. Districts that have all schools in good standing are identified as good standing districts. Districts that have schools that are identified as CSI or TSI had an improvement status of focus in 2017-18 school year and currently has identification criteria for all students and subgroups are identified as target districts. Let's take a closer look at East Ramapo. Upon my arrival in 2015, we were shortly presented 2 months later, in January of 2016, with the identification of seven focus schools and one priority school, totaling eight schools on the NYSED accountability list as in need of improvement. For this reason, a collaborative and collective approach to establishing a strategic academic plan for student success was memorialized and institutionalized in the summer of 2016. With the strategic academic plan as the foundation of our operation, all 14 schools developed data-driven school improvement plans to address the needs of our schools. This data approach positioned our schools for the gains that we have seen over the past 2 years. And in those gains, we couch it as saying the growth that we've seen in the past 2 years, resulting in the following. 2016, five of our schools were in good standing. In 2017, six of our schools were in good standing. And we all celebrated Elmwood coming off of the list. And we are still celebrating Elmwood coming off of the list. I was there the other day and I just stood at the foyer and tears just started coming down because of the way it was and because of the way it is now. But at the same time, we had three schools in focus that had positioned themselves, because it takes 2 years, they positioned themselves to be ready to come off the list the next year. Well, any school with a subgroup of students consistently underperforming on the state's indicators, all right? Any school consistently underperforming on the state's indicators. We had Ramapo High School, Spring Valley High School, and we know that their graduation rate did not move forward in all subgroups as we wanted. Target districts were identified because of the identification of TSI schools. TSI, targeted and support improvement. Targeted support and improvement. A district that was in focus status during the 2017-2018 school year and whose all students group met the criteria for TSI identification is also identified as a target district. So we have two schools, Ramapo High School, Spring Valley High School, that are identified as targeted support and improvement. Now, who remembers what does that mean? Targeted support and improvement.
District.
I can't hear you.
District.
Uh-huh, I can't hear you.
District.
Uh-huh. So and the other one is CSI. Who manages that support?
State.
Who?
State.
Very good. So, Ramapo High School, Spring Valley High School, you are home with us, and we will continue to move forward. Give Ramapo High School a good round of applause. And you know why I'm saying a round of applause? Because we're beginning with the end in mind. Remember the criteria as given to us by ESSA is already embedded where? In our mission and vision, in our five-point plan, and in our goals, and where else? In our curriculum, in our strategic plan, correct? Exactly. What we have to do is to do this work with fidelity. With fidelity. Did you see the 400 students? Mm-hmm. That was from one school. We are going
all the way up.
Exactly. Now, speaking of going all the way up and beyond, as stated, under the revised system, a district's determination is based on the identification of its schools. All students and subgroups to date, our high schools continue to move forward with a designation of TSI, Targeted Support and Improvement, indicative of the important work that we continue to engage in to strategically meet the needs of all of our students. As we actively drill down in our data and work to improve our graduation rate for all students, our district will continue to plan and manage the improvement of our high school as TSI schools requiring the oversight of
the district.
We continue to believe in our capacity to move all the way up. Continuing in the spirit, tied to the growth and progress of our schools and district, the following reflects the status of our remaining schools. All right, so East Ramapo Central School District, because there are our two high schools are targeted support and improvement, the district's designation is target district, okay? Yeah, we're home. All right, Chestnut Ridge Middle School.
Yeah.
say it. Let me try that again. Let me say it. Chestnut? Margaret, elementary. Thank you. need to hear from you. 1 minute. Would I keep the music playing? ECC?
You start the party, y'all.
Good evening, everyone. There is all about empowerment, the belief that you can and you will. Thank you.
Raising me up and when I'm raised.
raise others. So I just want to let you know that I have the best teachers and the best students in this district, and we can do it without them. So thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
a journey where we had to release to the teachers. First year, we did so much PD for principals, and they were like, tell. So then we started our leadership networking action, and we had to bring teachers in to lift up the arms of the principals so that we could really get that PD turnkey, right? We have a meeting this week where we had almost 100 people here. Now, I need teachers to do something, principals to do something. Give those tubes to your teachers. Teachers, open the tubes. Has been measured by the national statistics,
been measured by the statistics that were approved by the New York State Department of Education. The criteria is wider. But yet the criteria was wider, you were able to meet the mark. We know we had schools that were in the waiting because of the identification last year, but because the measures were wider and they were in concert with our school improvement initiatives, our systemic initiatives, 12 of our schools have been identified as good standing. Now, we want to say that we have only just begun.
That's right.
We must maintain good standing, hard work, proud of it, and we are going all the way up.
And beyond!
And we are not afraid
to be brave.
We are not afraid
to be brave.
We are not afraid
to be brave.
Have a great day. Congratulations to our K-8 schools. We are going all the way up.
And
thank you.
If you're in good standing, have a seat, please. Don't go yet. Don't go yet. Just give me 2 more minutes. I need my board president to greet you. See what good standing looks like? Feels good, doesn't it? Even with a broader category, with a wider category. Yeah. I give you our board president, Mr. Harry Grossman.
Thank you. I think I speak for everyone on the board, both the current board as well as whoever has served on the board over the past 3 years since Dr. Wortham has joined the district, that this is truly a great night for East Ramapo. We're not done yet. There's still more work to do. We're not done yet. We have more to go. That's why it's all the way up and beyond. But that being said, this is truly a milestone to be commended. It didn't come easily. It's a lot of work, a lot of effort, tremendously appreciated. Thank you.
And that concludes the superintendent's report.
And I just want to add, when you set the bar high, it just means you can go even higher. It's just like pole vaulting. You reach a certain height, you go to the next level up, is you just keep going and going and going and keep pushing the bar higher. So
I want to say to Mr. Grossman, Mr. Weiss-Mandel, former president, that it was under your leadership that we were able to put measures in place. I have to say, Mr. Weiss-Mandel, the very first board meeting, or maybe it was the second board meeting, and we presented Star Renaissance. It was the first indication of our forward movement. Star Renaissance actually tells us where we are and the strategies that we need to address in order to get stronger, better, and smarter. Our systemic initiatives, our theory of action, you put those to the plow. Teachers, you put it to the plow. And I will continue to celebrate you and to celebrate your questions, to celebrate answers to some questions. Might not be the question that you asked, but good answer to some question. But that was funny, y'all. You know I'm going to love you live, right? So I truly thank every person in this district. This is just an indication of the hard work. We have one of our consultants here with us tonight, Mutu Fegbaye. Mutu Fegbaye. You are not a stranger to us. He is our data guru. I want to thank my cabinet, specifically Ms. Natisha McVeigh. I'm going to thank Ms. Tamar Walker. I'm going to thank Ms. Ogechi Iwaha. These are our curriculum people. We work on a skeleton crew, but we try so hard to serve you. And so with that, I want to thank our finance people, Mr. Walter Patchy. New to the work, but still solid, Dr. Alex Marrero. the man who carries the title Fines. Always be nice to Dr. Shanahan. And then we call it our small and table but mighty. Listen, Michael Smith, world famous. Melissa Barrow, multi-millionaire. New to the house, but really moving it forward, Director of Transportation, Mr. Swagler. And Mary, who keeps everybody employed, Mary Swagler. I want to thank the board. I want to thank the board for the smiles and the challenges. I want to thank the board. Thank you all so very much. So when you walk out of that door, we've got to keep it going with fidelity. Go out, spread the word. We are East Ramapo, and we are not afraid to be great. You bring me joy, and I am grateful to all the sacrifices that you make. You have no idea, no idea. This is a day that I knew would happen. I knew it would happen. When Astrid Johnson told us about that song, she didn't tell me about the lyrics. She told us about that song. She had us all, there she is, had us all dancing. And then we had to change the lyrics, but we hung on to Rise Up, Rise Up. But the systems are in place. Now, we cannot rest on past laurels. We must work harder than even before to continue to get every child. We celebrated growth, and that's what helped move us into where we are today. Focusing on the data, get those data walls, polish them now, polish them, keep it going. I think you all better go before I keep talking. Say goodbye to Kathy on your way out, everybody.